Hello YouTube, how are you doing today? Welcome to a new FIFA 21 video. In this video, I'm gonna show you, in my opinion, the best way to play with Manchester City at this moment. This is how I like to play with them. If you wanna try it out yourself, make sure you watch the whole video, set everything the same up like I did, and well, go into a match, try it out, and let me know in the comments what you think of it and what your results are. I'm gonna show you the best formation, lineup tactics, and instructions, and as you see here in the background, I'm playing against someone who was playing with Liverpool. It was a really tough opponent, but we won with 3-0. So that's a pretty good result. Of course, it's all in online seasons. Before we begin, I really want to ask you to drop a like under the video if you learned something new from this video. It will be really helpful for me if you will do that. If you are new to the channel and you want to make sure you find your way back, make sure you are subscribed with notifications on so you don't miss any new videos that I'm posting. All right, let's start with the formation. It's the 4-3-3 holding formation for Manchester City. Edison is the goalkeeper, of course. Cancelo is the right defender. I'm playing with Walker as a center back, and I'm doing that because of his pace. 92 pace is really, really fast for a center back. I know his possession is not center back, but he's doing the job really good over there. And yeah, I played so many games in FIFA this year, and I'm using so much times fullbacks as a center back, and it doesn't matter that much in the game. And we all know that pace is really important. You are facing really fast attackers from your opponent, so it's pretty necessary to have at least one good and fast center back. So Walker is doing that for me. The other one is Ake. I know he's not the best defender in this squad, but I also choose him because he is the fast center back in this squad. But if you don't mind about the pace, you can also use Stones, Laporte, or Diaz. But for me, pace is really important, so that's why I'm using Ake. The left side of the defense, we have Mendy. All right, the most defensive midfielder, there he is, Rodri. Then we're playing with two central midfielders, De Bruyne and Silva. On the right side of the attack, we are using Mahrez. Aguero is the striker and Sterling is the left winger. Then we are going to the tactics. Defensive style is balanced with a width of 4 bars and a depth of 5 bars. Offensive style is also balanced. We need to change it. Balanced with a width of 7 bars and plays in the box also 7 bars. Corners and free kicks both 3 bars. Now we're going to the instructions. Cancelo, the only thing I changed for him is overlap. So we're using him with balanced attack. Most of the times I'm using stay back while attacking. If you think this is a bit too attacking for you and your fullbacks are just way out of possession, if you have that feeling, you can change it to stay back while attacking, of course. But for me, balanced attack and overlap run type is good. Walker and Ake are just default, and Mendy the same as the right defender. Only thing I changed is run type overlap. So attacking runs is balanced attack. And I'm saying it again, if it's too attacking for you or you think your fullbacks are not doing the job really good, put them on stay back while attacking. All right, then we're going to Rodri, the most defensive midfielder. There he is, cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking and cover center. Then we're going to De Bruyne, get forward, stay on the edge of the box for the cross, cover center and free roam. That's a lot of instructions, but he's doing a really amazing job. The same for Silva, get forward, get into the box for the cross, cover center and free roam. So Silva can go into the box for the cross. De Bruyne is staying on the edge of the box for the cross. If you put them both on staying in, if you put them both to get into the box for the cross, it's a bit too much. And De Bruyne, his shooting, his distance shooting is pretty good. So if you are crossing and your opponent is heading or shooting the ball away and De Bruyne can get the ball, try to shoot and score your goal. It's really amazing. Power that he has. So two really attacking midfielders, but it's paying out if you are playing it a good way. All right, Mahrez, the only thing that I'm doing is get in behind and get into the box for the cross. Then we have Aguero, stay central. And we have Sterling on the left side getting behind and getting into the box for the cross. All right, that's it for Manchester City. You also have some really good substitutes. I used Foden, I used Jesus as substitutes. They are really good players as well to have them on the bench. It's a really wonderful, wonderful weapon. So you have some fresh players during the second half. All right, this is it, the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.